Welcome to Parallel and Perpendicular Lines. The goals of this video are to determine if two lines are parallel or perpendicular, and also to determine the equation of lines that are parallel or perpendicular. Parallel lines are two lines that never intersect. Two lines are parallel if they have the same slope and different y-intercepts. So if they're both in sloped-intercept form, m1 must equal m2, and B1 cannot equal B2. Let's explore this idea with an applet. If you want to try it yourself, I would encourage you to visit the website. So here we have a line. Let's go ahead and place these points so we can easily determine the slope. The slope would be negative 2. To go from point A to point B, we'd go down 2 and right 1. Now if we introduce a second line, let's put these two points so that the slope is also negative 2. So if I put the first point here and the second point here, again, if we go down 2 and right 1, we're on this red line, and you can see those lines are parallel. They continue on forever, and they would never intersect. Now, as soon as I change the slopes, they're not the same. Of course, they intersect. Again, if I place them back where the slope is the same, they're parallel, but notice that this one crosses the y-axis at approximately 1, this one crosses at approximately 7. The reason that the y-intercepts must be different, because if they were the same, of course, the lines would be on top of each other. So the slopes must be the same, the y-intercepts must be different. Again, here's a picture you can probably see a little bit better. You can see these lines are parallel, they would never intersect, and if we check the slopes, we basically have to find two points, find the rise over the run. If I go up 1 and right 2, this slope would be 1/2, and of course on the red line, if I go up 1 and right 2, the slope is also 1/2. Perpendicular lines are lines that intersect and form a right angle, or a 90 degree angle. Two lines are perpendicular if the product of the slopes is negative 1, or if the slopes are negative reciprocals. The only exception to this rule is if one line is vertical and the other is horizontal, they're also perpendicular. So here's what we mean. If the lines are on sloped-intercept form, they're perpendicular if m1 times m2 is equal to negative 1, or if they're negative reciprocals. Let's view an example of this. If I ask you to find the slope of the blue line, picking these two points, if I go up 1 and right 2, the slope of the blue line is positive 1/2. If we try to find the slope of the red line using these two points, we would go down 2 and right 1. Well, down 2 and right 1 gives us a slope of negative 2 over 1. These are negative reciprocals of one another. Basically, you flip it over and change the sign. Therefore, they must be perpendicular lines or intersect at a right angle. The other check is to find their product. Positive 1/2 times negative 2 over 1, of course, is negative 2 over 2, which is equal to negative 1. That's another way to check to see if lines are perpendicular. Let's go ahead and look at an example. Determine if these lines are parallel, perpendicular, or neither. So let's start by comparing the slopes. Well, luckily, this first line is in sloped-intercept form, so we'll say that m1 is equal to 2/3. In order to find the slope of this line, we're going to have to solve it for y, or put it in y equals mx plus b form. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's add the x term to the other side. So we have 3y equals 2x plus 3. Let's divide by 3. We can go ahead and stop here and determine that the slope of the second line is also 2/3. Now remember, that's not enough information to determine that they're parallel. We also have to compare the y-intercepts. This y-intercept is equal to negative 4. This y-intercept would simplify to positive 1. So we have the same slopes, different y-intercepts. Therefore, we can conclude that the two lines are parallel. If we wanted to, we could graph it to verify. Let's take a look at another example. Same question, different equations. So we have to solve both equations for y to put them in slope-intercept form. So let's take our first line, subtract 2x on both sides, and divide by positive 5. So we have y is equal to negative 2/5 x plus 9/5. So let's go ahead and record our information. We know the slope is equal to negative 2/5, and the y-intercept is equal to 9/5. Let's solve the second equation for y. So we'll subtract 10x on both sides. So negative 4y is equal to negative 10x plus 12. We'll divide by negative 4. So this simplifies to a positive 5/2 x minus 3. So we have a slope of 5/2 and a y-intercept of negative 3. Well, the slopes aren't the same, so they can't be parallel. If they're perpendicular, the slopes must be negative reciprocals. Positive 5/2, negative 2/5, those are negative reciprocals. Or if we wanted to find their product, we'd have negative 10 over 10, of course, equal to negative 1. So these lines are perpendicular. Now we'll take a look at this from a different direction. Determine the equation of the line that is parallel to x minus 3y equals 9 and passes through the point 6, 2. Well, if the new line is parallel to this line, we need to start by finding the slope of this line. So we'll solve this for y. We'll subtract x on both sides, divide by negative 3. So we have y is equal to, this would be negative 1 over negative 3, or 1/3 x minus 3. So the slope of this line is equal to 1/3. Well, if our line is parallel to this, our slope must also equal 1/3, and it must pass through the point 6, 2. So if we're trying to find the equation of this line in slope-intercept form, we already know the slope. So remember, in order to find the y-intercept, we can replace x with 6 and y with 2, since this point is on our line, and that'll allow us to solve for b. Looks like our value for the y-intercept is 0. Therefore, the equation of the line that we're looking for is y equals 1/3 x. Again, I would encourage you to graph these two lines to verify, but again, we can already see that our slopes are the same, our y-intercepts are different, so it should be parallel. Let's take a look at one more. Determine the equation of a line that is perpendicular to y equals 4 and passes through the point negative 3, negative 2. So this one doesn't fit the normal pattern of what we're used to. So let's go ahead and graph some of this information on the coordinate plane. We know our line is perpendicular to y equals 4. So we know that y equals 4 is a horizontal line that looks something like this. So right away, we should be able to recognize if our line is going to be perpendicular to this, it must be a vertical line. Now let's also plot our point, negative 3, negative 2. That would be the point here. So the question really is, what is the equation of the line that is vertical and passes through that given point? Well, if you remember the equations of horizontal and vertical lines, y equals some constant is always a horizontal line, and x equals some constant is always a vertical line. So if this line passes through the point negative 3, negative 2, the equation of this vertical line must be x equals negative 3. Any point on this vertical line will have an x-coordinate of negative 3. I hope this short video helped explain the properties of horizontal and vertical lines. Thank you for watching and have a good day.